Okay, 54 seconds to go. I don't know what to expect. As usual, I've tried to go in as blind as possible. The only thing I know that is definitely here is they're going to show Mortal Kombat 1 gameplay. That's, apart from that, it's kind of totally going in totally blind. You might see an alert that pops up. I'm going to be doing the same as I did for the Sony thing the other night. I'm not going to read the chat very much. I'm just going to try and focus on this and kind of react to it. So don't think I'm ignoring you. I'm not. It's just that I find it very difficult to split my attention between both the chat and what's going on screen. I'll have a look at the chat occasionally though. I'm not going to completely ignore you. Okay, I think this is for like 2 hours as well. So get comfy. All right, come on. Hopefully they got some good shit.
Please welcome to the stage, the creator of the Game Awards, Jeff Keighley.
Jeff. Bring that down very slightly. I think we're there.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Summer Game Fest.
Where's Kojima?
We are in person, and today we've got a look at what's next in video games for you. We are live here in Los Angeles at YouTube Theater, and it feels so good to be in person with a live fan audience for the first time ever. Welcome, everybody.
Probably going to show Death Stranding 2, I would imagine, aren't they? Something.
When I started Summer Game Fest back in 2020 from a spare bedroom, I never imagined it would grow into this. Today, the video game industry has come together to show you what's next. This is a cross-industry showcase, meaning no matter where you play games, I hope you'll discover a new game to put on your wish list. The landscape of video game events has certainly changed over the past few years, but one thing hasn't. There are a lot of great games in development, and our singular goal today is to get you excited about the future. In just a few minutes, we'll see the first extended gameplay of Mortal Kombat 1.
Okay, so starting off with the only thing I knew about, which is
it
good.
It delivers, don't worry. Alan Wake 2, the reveal of Fortnite's next season.
Don't care.
And yes, we do have a very special grand finale that you're not going to want to miss.
He said grand
say right now.
Finale. Grand
well,
Theft
let's
Auto?
Let's get right to the games and gameplay. The first reveal is something you're not expecting, which makes it that much more exciting.
That's what I like. I better not be expecting it, Jeff. Oh. It's Sands of Time? Or it's not Sands of Time?
It's cursed. The prince has been kidnapped and taken to a forbidden land.
Is it just actually a new Prince of Persia?
With us, the immortals, to rescue him and save the Empire. But we weren't prepared for what was coming next. Then again, they weren't prepared for me.
All right, this looks good. So we're going old school Prince of Persia, but with like cooler combat. All right, the combat looks sick. Ubisoft, where's my climbing towers to reveal the map? Shit. Please.
Of darkness, hope is the only thing that keeps us fighting. I will fulfill my destiny and save the kingdom.
Are they just going to call it Prince of Persia? Oh no, okay. All right, yeah, that looks good. Actually got a date as well, that's good. Lovely. But yeah, what about Sands of Time? Is it just
There's
in the
a
bin
surprise.
Now?
Prince of Persia: The Lost Crown is coming in January 2024, a brand new action adventure platformer in the iconic series with deep combat, some huge boss fights, and of course, incredible platforming, puzzles, and animation, bringing a modern take on the legendary franchise. You'll be able to see more at Ubisoft Forward, streaming on Monday as part of Summer Game Fest. All right, let's move along to another iconic video game franchise that just celebrated 30 years. That's right. It's time for Mortal Kombat 1.
Oh, okay.
Couldn't keep you waiting on this one.
Mortal Kombat again.
It has been 4 years since MK11, and ever since, Ed Boon and the team at NetherRealm have been hard at work on the most ambitious MK yet that reboots the series into a new era timeline. And it's coming this September. Everyone has been asking, what does it look like? Who's on the roster? How do the new cameo fighters work?
Are they going to show off one of the... I do want to see what the cameos are.
No spoilers, but this video is literally insane. Here is an extended first look
literally
at the story,
insane
gameplay, and yes, of course, the fatalities of Mortal Kombat 1.
I'm going to say something controversial here. I've never really liked how Mortal Kombat's played. Always felt a bit like stiff.
I have had enough of you.
Then go before I put you down.
Fight.
It looks nice.
You have proven worthy of joining us. Come. There are other champions I must gather.
What do you want?
Sento. It's my family blade.
Sento's mine, and I won't give it up without a fight.
Oh, it says, okay. They got like tag teams in this? What's that? That was X-ray moves, wasn't it? It's like tag team X-ray moves?
Okay, let's go back to one here. Who are you again?
Lord Liu Kang, protector of Earthrealm, god of fire.
It's been a while since I've seen MK11. Does it look like that much better than MK11?
Raiden, but you're inexperienced.
I don't know.
Experience I lack, I make up for in heart.
Hey, it looks nice. I suppose we're kind of getting to that point now though, where it is like the visual upgrades are getting almost harder and harder to. Ooh, okay. They're getting kind of harder and harder to see, aren't they? Or it's less and less each time. For you,
or do you secretly covet my throne?
That's that was Goro. So bringing me, they're showing all like the, this is like all the OG characters, most of these, aren't they? I say OG, I mean like the first three or so. Jax. Ow. He's dead, mate. Okay. Fucking hell, mate. Do you think the people that make the fatalities, do you reckon they have fucking PTSD? classic fatality. Why the fuck should you have to pre-order to get a character, though? That's bullshit.
I mean, that was pretty good, right, guys? Now, I'm sure you have many questions about what we just saw, and to tell you more, I am so honored to welcome to Summer Game Fest one of our industry's greatest creators, a man who has been loyal to the same franchise and fan base for more than three decades. Please join me in welcoming to Summer Game Fest the creator of Mortal Kombat, Ed Boon!
Are they going to show off some of the cameo characters? It says, I know there's rumors of two.
They love
I've heard
all
about.
Right, well, Ed, first of all, thank you for that incredible world premiere. We got to see all the gameplay of MK1. And everyone just wants to know more about this. Because first of all, this is in a, it's MK1, right? It went from 11 to 1. So tell us about this. Is it a new timeline?
Yeah. I don't know how many people have seen the ending of Mortal Kombat 11. Liu Kang basically was kind of graduated into like
spoilers.
A fire god, right? And he created a brand new universe. And this universe, this is why we're calling it Mortal Kombat 1, is because this is the beginning of a new timeline. A number of these characters you've seen before, but they're told in a completely different story. And so Sub-Zero and Scorpion are brothers now, and there's all these things that were rivalries before are now allies, and so mixing the whole thing up. So we're just kind of rebooting, and that's what the one is for.
Well, it looks incredible. Everything we saw there was, you know, in-game gameplay. The cinematics look incredible. I know the team has been working for 4 years on this, but the thing we got to talk about are these cameos, because we saw some pretty amazing stuff there. Now, so tell us, how does that work? You have your sort of your main, you know, character that you'll pick, and then I know you also have a separate kind of cameo menu, so you pick sort of a pair when you start the game?
Yeah, normally in a fighting game, you'll see a roster, basically, you know, where you select your character. After you do that, there's a second roster of characters, which are a whole new, completely different fighters that are the cameo fighters, and these fighters actually, they will join the fight. But they,
a lot
but
of
they,
blank squares there.
Yeah, so it's kind of like imagine yourself with Sub-Zero, but you have some of Jack's moves, and you can call him out. You can do it multiple times, as you saw in the gameplay. You know, so you can you can basically combine these two characters. All the characters can be combined with all the cameo fighters, and that's where the player's kind of imagination comes in, and they can actually customize it for what they like seeing, you know, the best team-ups.
Well, so how does that work? So you're in gameplay, you have your main, you have your cameo. How do you summon them? Is it time-based? Like, how often do they come in? It's not a tag team thing, right?
Exactly. And you're basically summoning them. It's just one button push is basically summoning, but they have a variety. So you can go, you know, push that button with towards and it'll do a different move. Push it with down, it'll do a different move. Okay. And so the combination.
Oh, I see. So you can bring them in a combo almost.
Exactly. Okay. Exactly. And you see there's like a meter up on top, which is basic. That'll limit it. So you can't obviously fire them indefinitely, but you can call them pretty much whenever you want. And they have, you know, like in the middle of a combo, they'll have a lot of, you know, basically.
Does that mean you can't play as these characters, though?
So when you saw come out there, sometimes you'll see them appear twice in there.
It's amazing. So time-based, they come out.
So you can't play as Sonya,
as you go through, you revealed some of them there, but is it a different set of characters that'll be in the cameos? Are there some repeats from the main roster? How will that work?
Yeah. Some of the characters are going to be available as cameos as well as the main roster fighters. You can play Sub-Zero with Sub-Zero, right? You can same thing with Scorpion. But a lot of our cameo fighters are kind of like nods back to our first game. So you'll notice Sonya and Kano and Jax are in their kind of older costumes. And so there's a lot of that novelty. We have a lot of like really surprised ones. I think you guys saw Goro.
Yes, Goro was in there. Yeah. Exactly.
So there's a lot of like kind of really digging into the old Mortal Kombat games as far as getting, you know, we really love the novelty of it. We really want the cameo characters to feel, you know, kind of nod to the old games.
Well, speaking of nine of the old games, let's talk. You confirmed, I think, or it's at least known, that Jean-Claude Van Damme is actually going to be in this game as Johnny Cage, right?
Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah, he is.
What?
That was, yeah. People don't know the story. I mean, Bloodsport was such an inspiration for Mortal Kombat, so he finally is now part of it.
It's a huge first full circle moment. You know, the first Mortal Kombat game, we originally wanted to be Van Damme, the video game, and that never really worked out. So I can't tell you how many times over the last 30 years we've tried to get him. You know, we were this close, like 4 or 5 times. And so finally we got him, and he's doing the voices, too.
Wow.
So you're going to hear Jean-Claude, his voice doing Johnny Cage lines and stuff like that. We're really excited about it.
Wow. Well, I know the team has been working so hard in Chicago to build this through COVID, and it's coming out in September, so we don't have to wait long, right?
That's right.
Hello, by the way. I thought the backgrounds did look better as well, actually.
Over the last 4 years. And so, but
that's probably the biggest upgrade, but it looks
like we could not be more excited in terms of getting players' hands on it. And you know, throughout the summer, we're going to be showing a lot more
content. Yeah, it sounds like it, doesn't it?
Characters,
maybe a bit more grounded
characters, you know. So, there's a lot of reveals that are coming up.
Amazing. Well, Ed, thank you so much for giving us the first look at MK1. As you said, this weekend people will be playing it, press and media, so we'll be seeing lots more coverage, lots more characters to reveal on the main roster and cameos. Ed Boon, thank you so much. First look at Mortal Kombat. Awesome. Thanks so much. Amazing. So excited about that one. All right. Next up, it's been a fun couple weeks for action RPG fans with the release of Diablo 4, which is truly fantastic. Another big and anticipated ARPG is Path of Exile 2 from Grinding Gear Games, who have faithfully been updating and patching the original PoE since its release in 2013. We haven't seen anything on the sequel in over 2 years, but that changes right now. Here is your first look at a raw gameplay capture from Path of Exile 2, a sequel that pushes the engine and gameplay to a new level.
Jinx. I never played the original. I heard it was good though.
Hey you! What's going on?
Especially for a freebie. Yeah, I better read that. It's great, but it needs some dedication. From what I saw, the upgrade tree looks so intimidating. But I guess like any free-to-play game's got kind of like a dedication kind of thing going for it, hasn't it?
Looks amazing, and there's more coming in July. Last week marked the release of Street Fighter VI, a game we featured last year at Summer Game Fest. Well, the team at Capcom has an important update to share with you right now.
Our next character, I guess. What? Mecha Ryu? Oh wait.
Advanced artificial intelligence, Leviathan.
Why has he got a gun?
Welcome to Pikitoa Island.
Is this Exoprimal? Okay, yeah. Robo Ryu is in Exoprimal, okay. Sure. Ah, oh, Robo Guile. So it can be Robo Chun-Li, I guess. All right. I'm still not totally convinced by that game, but it's a Game Pass game. I can give it a go.
I'm guessing Ryu from Street Fighter facing off against a dinosaur probably wasn't on your bingo card for today's show.
It was not.
That Street Fighter Cross Exoprimal collab will launch in the fall with the game coming out on July 14th. But guess what, guys? That may actually not be the craziest collaboration on the show today. Check this out.
There's nothing more powerful than imagination.
Is that Nicolas Cage?
We can shape the fabric of reality, transforming everything you may think you know.
Okay, what's he in? Okay. Oh wait, no, we knew about this, didn't we? I think we already knew about that.
That's right. Nicolas Cage is coming to Dead by Daylight in July. I mean, I don't know how these things happen, but
what's he gonna do?
I figured the easiest way to find out is probably
bring him here.
Right to the source.
Yeah. All right.
This man's bold creative choices have earned him an Academy Award and a few memes on the internet across more than four decades of incredible films. Please join me in welcoming to Summer Game
yeah,
Fest,
Steal
Nicolas
the Declaration
Cage.
Of Independence. He's looking really good, isn't he? Like, he hasn't aged very much.
Happy to meet you.
Nick, I gotta say, welcome to the video game world.
Oh, wow, yeah, thank you. I'm so happy to be invited to your very, very cool club, everybody.
Finally, I mean, I gotta say, this is such a crazy, unexpected collaboration.
So jealous.
I gotta understand, how did this come about? I mean, some people be like, oh, maybe he'll show up in
Fortnite.
Sorry,
envious,
maybe he'll
I should say.
In the Hideo Kojima game, but Dead by Daylight, I mean, how does this happen?
Well, it's a museum of horror, right?
Yes.
And when I make movies, one of my favorite genres is horror. And in this, and in that genre, there's a character, a murderous ghost named Sadako, who I think is amazing. And she made an appearance in this game, so that was good enough for me.
Okay. That's what's fun is you're playing one of the survivors in this game, and it's cool that, you know, it really is this museum of horror. Michael Myers, you said all these different characters all coming together. And you, do you play yourself, or who do you play?
So I play this heightened, exaggerated version of a film actor named Nick Cage.
Fuck's sake.
he's going to a location thinking he's making a movie, and instead he wakes up in the fog. And in the fog, he's surrounded by crows and serial killers, and it's rather amusing. And there's something about it that I think, as a survivor, is like
oh, so he's not a killer. Okay,
experience.
Makes
it's
more
a bit
sense.
Like hide and go seek. You have your three other teammates who are survivors with you, and it's teamwork. You're working together to pull through, and I like that. And so that was a large reason for wanting to do it as well. That feeling of bonding with your friends.
And you're fully in for this. I know we heard your voice in there, recorded lines for it and everything.
See. I want you to know when you're playing the Nick Cage survivor, I even have when you're choosing your skins, I even say, always remember to dress to match your talent. I want you to know that you're with me, that we're one, that we're fused. And so it was important to me that everything I do, everything I say, from the scream to the grunt down to the most minimal exasperated expression of a sigh, whatever it is, it's my voice so that we are fused.
All right. Fully method, Nick.
Tarika,
I love it.
Jim Carrey could work.
I
mean, like, you could have the mask
so
as a killer.
This game, as you said, is such an awesome kind of, you know, collaboration with so many different characters. For you, I mean, how did you find out about Dead by Daylight? Do you know much about the video game?
Somebody
world?
Very important in my family is a Dead by Daylight enthusiast.
Okay.
And that really put the hook in. Ha, pun intended. See, Dead by Daylight to me was an opportunity to branch out. I've never been invited into this space before.
Yeah.
I'm always looking for new adventures. So this to me was like, wow, I can make a whole new audience, meet a whole new audience, and branch out and go on this Dead by Daylight adventure. I didn't say, it took me nothing but a split second to say yes. And speaking about split seconds, what I noticed was that every move you make when you're doing this, when you're in the gaming space, it's timed down to the split second. It's a very immersive experience when you're acting out in this space, because every move, every grunt, every sigh you make has to be timed perfectly with the gamer's move. So that was something that I learned from this, and I'm always looking to learn something.
Well, we love having you in the video game world. We want to see Nick Cage in more games.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
Nick, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hopefully the first many. Nicolas Cage, great to see you, man.
Put
awesome.
There,
there you go. Lock it in. All right.
We could have a Cornair
Dead by Daylight
game.
The chapter officially comes out on July 25th on PC and console, but PC players can try it earlier by downloading the player test build on July 5th. And here's an exclusive first look at Nicolas Cage in Dead by Daylight.
Is he going to have, like, different costumes for, like, different characters he's played in films?
Oh, made it.
That's so weird.
Anything goes here at Summer Game Fest.
Yeah, it's nice to see him kind of doing what he likes now, isn't it?
Lately, we've been seeing an incredible number of video game adaptations. But back in 2019, The Witcher on Netflix, inspired by the Witcher book series, showed the potential of well-done adaptations. And later this month, Season 3, Volume 1 arrives, and now it's time for the world premiere of the trailer, introduced by Henry Cavill and the cast.
Hello, Witcher fans. We are all gathered here today to share something with you.
Be sure to tune into The Witcher Season 3.
I still haven't seen the
Volume
second season yet.
Volume 1 debuts on June 29th, only on Netflix.
Get ready to watch the world premiere of our brand new trailer for Season 3 of The Witcher.
Thanks for tuning in to the Summer Games Fest and enjoy the trailer.
It's got to be a bit shit for Henry Cavill, isn't it? Having to, like, now that he's been kicked off of it. Wait, did he get kicked off or did he leave? I forget.
It won't get you a statue.
Yeah. Would love this if he finished. Would love it if he finished this by giving two middle fingers. he left. Okay. Yeah. It was fed up of not having any say, wasn't he?
You try to see his consequences too.
Because he's a big fan of the books, isn't he?
You're right.
Embrace.
Well, that's left before worrying. Kicked. Right. I thought it was really good.
It's all connected. I mean, she's at the center of it.
You've heard he can be a pain as well, though.
It's coming. There is no hiding her from it.
Like, not a cunt, but not easy. Well, it'd be like a bit stubborn,
sure you reckon?
Are you?
The thing about it is that he was being a dick to the writers and they had enough of it. Regardless of whether the writers deserved it, that shit can kill production. Yeah, I guess if, like, people are wrestling, like, you know, I understand that he's passionate about the franchise, right? But
the dangers we've seen foretell an even more.
I guess at the end of the day, you have to have, like, a hierarchy, right, of who gets to decide what's happening.
For the first time, I understand real fear.
Might be one of those things where you'll never really properly get the full truth, though.
Is that so?
I wouldn't say he's too old for Bond.
I'll never get over how cute they look for monsters. And they're like, no, please don't hurt me. And then wow! Fangs. Just like a boatload of fangs. All up in your business.
Ooh, I like playing Painkiller and Bulletstorm. I still need to see Man from Uncle. It's looking a bit bullet stormy, isn't it? More so than it does look like Painkiller, at least. Oh, I think we saw some of this, didn't we? I'm sure I've seen that before. I know I say this every time there's a VR thing, but trying to show off a VR game in a non-VR environment doesn't really sell what it's going to be like.
Let's go.
Wait, wasn't Crossfire the thing they just canned? They're doing a new one? Yeah, how much is that though? It's probably like $70 billion.
We have no choice. The root will destroy everything. For all.
Is this that Revenant game? Like an expansion or something? Get $50 off a $2,000 monitor.
No turning back after this. You sure?
It is Revenant, right? That's another game that's sitting in the pile of shame here somewhere. Oh yeah, look, I've got it right here. There you go. Always got it to hand somehow. I heard it was good. It kind of looks like a more solid Outriders than what I saw of it. Oh, okay, Remnant 2. There you go. Never mind. Just a new one. Whatever. Just casually dropping a second one in there.
All right, we have much more Summer Game Fest to come, including a first look at the gameplay of Alan Wake 2, the world premiere of the new season of Fortnite, Call of Duty Season 4, and maybe a few more surprises for you.
It better be, because if you're doing Call of Duty and Fortnite, I'm going to be fucking bored.
To react to the news, we want to welcome everyone co-streaming the show live on TikTok, Twitch, YouTube, and other platforms.
This is going to be the Fortnite update where they add Yakuza characters in.
Steinax Warframe for watching more than 30 minutes of the show. Now, speaking of surprises,
and then I have to play it.
Another legendary gaming hero is set to return later this year in a brand new game built from the ground up in a style that I think is going to get this fan base and longtime fans of video games very excited. Here's another Summer Game Fest global game announcement. New thrills with a classic feel.
Hey, what? I'm gonna piss my pants. Depends how it handles though. If they got the physics correct. I don't hate the 3D look in this one, like it, because Sonic 4 looks like shit. This actually looks pretty good. Okay. Ah, they're bringing back everyone's favorite special stage. Sonic Superstars. I'm not entirely convinced by that. Out knack. Oh, coming this year. Okay. Yeah, not entirely convinced by that.
How about that?
I need to see a bit more of that.
A classic Sonic that's bound to appeal to new and legacy fans alike. This past April, Honkai Star Rail launched, and as you're about to see, the game is bringing an exciting new character to space fantasy RPGs. However, we don't just have a new peak for current players.
That kind of looked like for those awaiting the they were going for like a new Super Mario Brothers kind of game. Do you reckon that's fair to say?
I wish this universe had a few more things to do. Don't you get bored running across the map every day?
Is this Honkai Star Rail?
Team Trailblaze, back from duty. Mission one accomplished. Where's our next stop? I can't wait.
Another busy day ahead of us.
Starting. Great. Let me get warmed up.
Wait, is it Genshin or is it Honkai? I missed it.
Need a hand? My pleasure. Let's see some sparks fly.
It's Honkai. Okay. Apparently Honkai is pretty good. What I've heard. As far as like a free JRPG goes.
Huh. Never mind. Miscalculated. Can you let me have some fun this time?
Oh yeah, it's the PS5 version. End of the year, okay.
Later this year on PlayStation. All right, inspired by the story of Pinocchio, Lies of P is a Soulsborne-like game.
Oh, this did look good. NeoWiz,
which is coming to Game Pass, PlayStation, and PC this year. Well, if you're wondering exactly when, we have news to share with you on its release with this brand new trailer.
It's out tomorrow. I reckon this is out soon because they've been threatening to release it for a while, haven't they? Totally not Bloodborne.
Je t'ai rencontré sans plus mot. Et tu n'as rien fait pour chercher.
It's like someone shoved Bloodborne and Nier Automata's worlds together. With Bioshock baddies. Yeah, that's not a dig, that's honestly quite a good combination. I'd quite like to see a bit more gameplay if possible. Oh, shark submarine!
Listen, pal. Nice landing, but let's not make it a habit.
September the 19th. Oh, demo now, okay. All right.
That's right, a demo for Lies of P is now available across
just calling
PlayStation,
it French Bloodborne.
Xbox, and PC. Check it out and prepare for the release on September 19th. Now it's time for the reveal of a visually stunning new game based on a classic manga with a story and world created by one of the most celebrated anime artists of all time. This is one of those games that I feel lucky we get to reveal for the first time here at Summer Game Fest.
And One
I
think Piece, please.
Once you see the gameplay, all built in Unreal Engine 5. Here we go.
Ooh.
Hmm.
can't tell. Okay, so it's a... Oh, wait. What's the name of this one again? It's the Toriyama one. I forget the name of it. Sandland, that's it. Is this the one they're just about to do an anime of? A movie, okay. She says you can bet on me. It's always better. She says she gets just what she needs. Yeah. Toriyama has to have a little pink goblin creature, doesn't he? Alright. I don't think it's out yet, Taruka.
Sandland, get ready to become an unlikely hero in an adventure where you don't need to be human to save humanity. That's coming from Bandai Namco, and we're excited to see more of it soon. Independent games are such an important part of the industry, and one thing that's very important to us at Summer Game Fest is supporting those creators as well. After the live show, stay tuned for Day of the Devs from IM8Bit and Double Fine with some incredible indie game reveals. Now, one of the biggest independent publishers is Annapurna
Interactive. I'm going to stick around for that, by the way.
And later this month, as part of Summer Game Fest, they'll be revealing a number of ambitious new projects. Let's see how many you can figure out in this little tease.
Okay. Stray, I still need to play this. Outer Wilds. I forget the name of it. Forget the name of that as well. Neon White, was it? Neon White, that's it. And Solar Ash, that's it. That was the other one. Annapurna usually do some good stuff.
I wonder what that was at the end. We'll find out later this month. All right, next, we're stepping into the world of
Throne and Wilds
Liberty,
too.
A free-to-play PC and console MMORPG from NCSoft and Amazon Games.
Nice resolution on that screen.
Environment, massive scale, PvPvE, and the ability to transform into creatures to battle across land, sea, and air. Here's a look at Throne and Liberty.
That looks like a fucking mobile game, like title.
Our guiding star has shattered. Its shards scattered across the world.
NCSoft still exists.
An ancient evil searches for these lost fragments, destroying anything in their path. You must find them. Their power.
The thing is this going to be another like MMO, like Korean MMO with insanely cool looking combat, but like the most grindy gameplay of all time? That looks a bit Dragon's Dogma-y, actually. Like, combat-wise. Alright, I mean, that looks pretty good. Is it an MMO, though? I don't know. I can't tell if it's like a single player or not. I feel like it's a fucking dreadful name. Like, I'm gonna just forget that. Oh, it is an MMO. Okay. Yeah.
Looks great. I also want to say hello to everybody watching on Steam right now. I'm sorry we don't have any free Steam decks for you right now. But on June 19th, Steam Next Fest does return, giving fans a chance to try out hundreds of new in-development games. One of them is the free-to-play medieval fantasy sword-fighting game Warhaven from Nexon, which lets you transform into supernatural immortals. Here's a new look.
Get wrecked. Hear the battle call. Cities rise and empires fall. But it's a war worth fighting. We're taking up our arms. Pull the line up. So it's a multiplayer game? Got all of those bars and shit all over the place? I don't know if it's unfair to say this, but a lot of these games seem to kind of just like blend together. It's like a more fantasy-like chivalry. It's definitely a multiplayer game, isn't it? Play for free.
Hey, this is not.
Why can't I?
Are they still advertising this fucking game? I keep forgetting. Again, I forget what it's called. But it feels like they've shown this at the last two or three years. Party Animals. Yeah, it's legally distinct gang beasts.
Pilgrims, summer is coming, and with it, a lot of cool stuff will make its way to Dying Light to stay human. Get ready for darker, more dangerous nights and roaming volatiles, complete with improved parkour, rolling out with the next update in June. Then, right after that, we'll kick off an event season like you have never seen before. Trust me, for one of them, you will want to get your butt barbed wired. Very soon, you will get the deadliest
It sounds like you said butt. It said bat. This looks... This... Oh, dear. But even the internet doesn't like it. This looks... dreadful to me. Not my kind of game, I suppose, but I can't imagine this is what Crash fans want. I was just gonna say, I really appreciate how much the Dying Light team support the game. Like, they really, like, they're always updating those games. Dying Light 1 got supported for like 3 or 4 years, didn't it? After it came out. Gang Beast was funny as fuck, yeah. Yawn.
Welcome back to Summer Game Fest. Isn't that great? By the way, Crash Team Rumble is going to feature playable Ripper Roo and Engine. Neocortex's right-hand guy in
Oh, yeah, that game one. Isn't free to play, by the way.
It's time
that Crash
to
one.
Change the topic and descend
I don't
into
think.
Madness. Joining me is a guy who was last on stage at the Game Awards 2021 to announce Alan Wake
2. Is it Sam Lake?
He's come all the way from Finland. Please welcome
Love
from
Sam
Remy,
Lake.
Sam Lake.
He's another man that doesn't seem to fucking age.
Good to see you. looking dapper as always.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, we are so excited because when you announced Alan Wake at the Game Awards, Alan Wake 2 at the Game Awards, you said 2023. We are in 2023. It's coming this October, and we are so excited about this, Sam. I know it's been a long time coming for fans and for you, 13 years since the first Alan Wake. So tell us a bit about what can we expect in the sequel.
It's been quite a journey, yes.
Yeah.
Alan Wake 2 is Remedy's first survival horror game. We have two playable characters. It's a 50-50 split between them. They are on their own separate terrifying journeys through two different worlds, and yet it's all connected. Mm. And the player gets to switch between them at given points in the story as they choose.
Yeah, we saw, obviously, at the PlayStation event, you revealed Saga, the second character. Tell us a bit about her. She's in Bright Falls, and she's sort of living a narrative that Alan has written. Is that right?
Well, that's a good question to ask into this. So, yes, we have Alan Wake, our title character, of course, trying to escape from the nightmare dimension of the dark place.
Yes.
And then we have Saga, our new hero, FBI agent, coming to the Pacific Northwest small town of Bright Falls together with her partner, Alex Casey.
Okay.
So he plays him. But it's his face.
They are coming to investigate
a
series of ritualistic murders.
Okay.
And very quickly, the investigation turns into a nightmare when they discover pages of a horror story.
Didn't love Alan Wake, just didn't enjoy the gameplay.
Missing writer.
I can understand. I really liked it.
And this horror story starts to come true.
I think I just really liked the setting, and it was kind of unique at the time.
Obviously, it's, you know, Alan is still going to be playable in the game. You're going to experience his journey, but Saga, this is sort of new character, and there is that sort of link. Tell us a bit about, you said split 50-50. Do they have separate missions? Because I think you can play them in sort of different sequences or orders if you want, right?
Yeah, we go into the experience playing as Saga.
Okay.
And it's a sequel, but it's also a standalone experience. We are not expecting everybody to do homework if they have not played the original game.
Yeah.
This can be enjoyed as is. Saga doesn't know anything about the lore, about the supernatural in this world. She will be going in very quickly. She has to learn to survive. And with that, all the players will be on that journey with her. And then we open up the experience so that you can hop to play Alan Wake in the dark place as he's trying to find his way out. And you can keep on playing as Saga in the Pacific Northwest as the investigation goes on. And you are free to switch between them. Ah. There are a lot of connection points in many surprising ways, but there is no right way to play through this. You can choose. You can go on as Alan all the way close to the end, or as Saga, or you can keep hopping between these two sides of it.
Well, you're always so good at kind of telling challenging, interesting narratives in unique ways. I mean, Remedy's always been known for that, and you especially, so we can't wait to see how these stories intertwine, I'm sure, throughout the experience. Today, though, I know you brought with you some gameplay of Saga's adventure.
We're just going to
see
a
raw segment of the game, right?
Yeah, raw gameplay for the first time ever. This is early on from the experience.
They're hyped, Sam. They're ready for it. So tell us, what are we going to see?
Supernatural forces of darkness have brought the murder victim, in this case, back to life as a monster. And Saga is outside Bright Falls at Cauldron Lake trying to find him and stop him.
Okay, with that, let's take a look at raw, unedited gameplay from Alan Wake 2.
Thanks, see, I wonder how her gameplay works. You have to still burn the shadows off of enemies.
Sounds like somebody's home.
I'm liking the minimal HUD. Hey, Kel. Okay, yeah, so you still have to burn it off. Right, so judging by that, combat's very, very similar. Shotty. Nice.
The text on the heart is clearer now. Legible. I knew it would be here. Like I saw it in a dream.
I'm glad you're on this case with me, Anderson. Killer left a message.
It's for us.
I love that they brought the Max Payne VA back.
Story. The horror story wanted us dead.
He does look like John Wick, doesn't he?
I'm forgetting. Something important. Something's not right.
A long time coming.
That, this one looks a bit more grimy, doesn't it?
Sam and Remedy for
the first game was, I don't know, just a bit more clean.
Let's get a first look
this is
at
a bit more like Silent Hill.
Of Warhammer Space Marine 2 from Saber and Focus.
There's co-op in Space Marine 2? I didn't know that.
We're facing a Tyranid splinter fleet.
This is going to be sick.
Two planets, Avarax and Kadaku. I'll be straight with you, Titus. I have my reservations about your reinstatement. There could be questions. That'll be a problem. No, Captain.
Did it? I don't remember that.
Tyranids!
I'm really down for another one of these.
My pledge is eternal service. Xenos inbound! Eviscerate this abomination! Come forth and be slaughtered. Open the gates.
Care to see if we can slay more Xenos for the Chiron?
I thought a beast of that stature would offer more sport.
Hold them back, damn it!
For the Emperor!
Yeah, that looks cool. Next gen only. Well, I should say current gen, shouldn't I? Oh, is this... No, it's not, actually. I was thinking Avowed. That's the cyberpunk one. This looks like that, but medieval? My potatoes! I was thinking of my cabbages. Oh, okay. Yes, Your Grace is that one where, like, your Twitch viewers can decide if they want to fuck you over or not, right?
Beautiful indie game, Yes, Your Grace, Snowfall. Now it is time for another global game announcement, and this one comes from the minds of Saber Interactive, Focus Entertainment, and yes, horror master John Carpenter. It's a brand new world, a brand new story, and looks like a heck of a lot of fun. Check this out.
Can we let John Carpenter do a Dead Space movie, please? That would be rad. Yeah, 80s butt rock.
We gotta be ready. Nobody half-asses it this time.
Oh, the Event Horizon game would be awesome. I mean, it's that is kind of Dead Space, though, isn't it? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Toxic Commando. That's a fucking great name. You know this is going to be serious, don't you? Right, so we're going for the Left 4 Dead crown again, I guess, are we? Looks like this one might be a bit more open world or something. I know Back 4 Blood gets shit on a lot, but I thought that was alright, honestly. This looks pretty good, though. Toxic Commando is a fucking great name. I love it. That's like big dumb video game name.
More unexpected collaboration. John Carpenter and Saber with Toxic Commando. That looks tons of fun. You guys think any of those zombies made it? All right. Well, this August brings the long-awaited full 1.0 release of Baldur's Gate 3. And today, a new member is joining the cast. We're about to see the reveal of Lord Emvor Gortash, the commander of a mechanical army of Steel Watchers. He's a second antagonist and is voiced by a familiar name.
Yeah, I had fun playing it with you guys. Has anyone been playing the early access
Emvor
of this?
Emvor Gortash. Swearest thou by Baldurin's blade to defend the citizens of Baldur's Gate from enemies within and without?
You are soon to witness the people of Baldur's Gate granting me complete power over them.
Izzy's down.
A new age is upon us. Gods have mercy.
Oh, love Jason Isaacs.
A mad dog understands the yank of the leash and the hand of its master, but it cannot be an equal. You can be my equal. There's an old wisdom. A brittle alliance can never be mended. It can only break. I want to lead this city to glory, not scorch its earth.
Friends, allies, to my side. Let us usher in a new dawn. This city is mine.
I'm not ready to call you enemy. What do you say? Shall we be allies?
I think this is... Isn't this out this year? September or something? August.
You said it was under control.
It isn't you I answer to. Gortash.
I don't know who that is.
Baldur's Gate 3 is on track, Sven tells me still, for the end of August, and we can't wait to check that out. All right. This fall, Marvel Games and Insomniac are set
in August,
to bring
Kel,
Spider-Man
yeah.
2 exclusively to PlayStation 5. Sounds like you guys are a little hyped. So to tell us more is Brian Intihar, game director at
Insomniac. I wasn't expecting
Brian,
them to show any more of this. I thought they were going to just keep it all at the
First
Sony
of all,
thing.
Looks
but...
like we have some fancy art behind us. This is this the box?
This is the box art. This is, you know, this is it. Here it is. I mean, it has two on the box for a reason, because this game features two Spider-Men, so we're really excited about it.
Absolutely. Peter and Miles, we're so excited about this you know, experience that you guys are doing with these sort of two characters. We saw some great gameplay at the PlayStation Showcase, but I want to talk about the two villains, I think, in the game. There may be more.
There are more out there, I
promise.
Two
main ones, but we have some new art to show of, we obviously, Kraven, we got the reveal at the PlayStation event. So tell us a bit about him and how he factors
in. So Kraven's very different from any character we've done. He's not, you know, he's not powered by magic or, you know, tech. He's just the best hunter in the world, and he's coming to New York for his greatest hunt. And what's better than all of the Marvel characters that live in New York City? So Peter, Miles, and others. He's on the hunt.
And others, dot, dot, dot.
Yes, yes.
But Venom also, obviously, you know, Symbiote is a part of this whole story, as we saw in the gameplay. Oh, there you go. Good reaction to the art.
I'm glad you're happy.
I don't know how much you're going to tell us about Venom. Is this, can you tell, is this an Osborn Venom? Can you tell, what's the origin of Eddie Brock Venom? Or?
It is not Eddie Brock.
Okay.
It is not Eddie Brock.
Okay.
Our goal was to tell an original story, something you haven't seen in the comics or the movies yet. Obviously, we love Venom for a reason.
Yeah.
All those things you love about the character are going to be there, but how the story plays out, who is Venom, you have to play the game to see how it goes.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. There's a bit of a tease. Now, obviously, the symbiote is a big part of the gameplay, and one of the things I think we were all struck with the footage that you showed at the PlayStation Showcase was, you know, how that is going to really impact the gameplay when you're playing as, you know, Peter. So tell us a bit about that and how, you know, the gameplay is going to be dramatically different.
Yeah, I mean, I think you saw it in just the raw power, the strength, and even the transformation of Peter's moves in that gameplay reveal.
Yeah.
You know, we call him the acrobatic improviser, him and Miles, but you can tell there's a lot more strength, a lot more raw power, aggression, which you saw both in the moves and how Peter talks. So it's not just what happens in gameplay, it's what happens, how the story plays out.
Interesting. So how it affects him as well.
Yeah. I mean, you saw some of that in there's much more of that journey when you play the game.
And I know the journey is also more expansive. You've got Queens, Brooklyn, so even more of sort of
the city is pretty much doubled in size. So it's Manhattan, Queens, Brooklyn, and then being able to use the web wings to traverse at speeds way faster than they were before is really awesome.
Hugely ambitious game you guys have been building over the past few years. We saw at the PlayStation event, it said at the end, fall 2023, and I think... You know, we're like getting close to that. Are you guys feeling confident that you're going to make it this fall?
You know, Jeff, I know you like exclusives.
Yes.
And I can promise you we're
November.
Very confident what we're going to tell you right now.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's take a look.
November 12th. I'm going to pull a number out my arse here. Okay, I was close. I was close.
Nailing it, October.
Only 3 weeks out.
Spider-Man 2, exclusively for PlayStation 5.
Got it.
Awesome. Well, Brian, thanks so much for stopping
by.
I know you got a lot of work to do. Wrapping up the game, but we'll check it out in October. Thanks, Brian. We got our date. All right. Now let's take a look at Pal World, a multiplayer open-world survival crafting game where you can befriend and collect mysterious creatures called Pal, who can also fight. In
this
other
is
words,
the fucking
like Pokemon with guns.
Knockoff Pokemon bullshit, isn't
then
it?
Then we're going to look at The Land of the Morning Light, a new expansion to Black Desert Online, which recreates the mythical folktales from Korea's Joseon Dynasty, and some huge bosses, too.
I don't know how they haven't been sued, honestly. That's just... What's that sheep one called? Is it Wooloo? How the fuck have they not been sued? What is going on? They look so similar to Pokemon. Fuck off. It looks shit. Fuck off. Now, talking of the Korean MMO with cool combat that is super grindy, here's the ultimate one. Amazing character creator in this game as well.
Our story is more than what hobbits and elves know.
Oh god, it's not the Gollum team, is it?
Time we told it ourselves.
Bless them.
With hammer and axe, we mine and scout. Across Middle Earth, delving for riches.
Oh, if this, imagine if this was a Deep Rock Galactic expansion.
Greatest treasure remains out of our reach. Moria.
Rock and stone. It's not like a dungeon keeper type game, is it? This is a survival game.
My fellow dwarves, rally together. It's time we took back our home.
Okay. Might have to give that a look. Oh good, we're getting the same adverts twice. I know they've got to get their like sponsor money from somewhere, but fucking hell. Less of this, please.
All right, now we're going to look at an exciting new mobile game from a legendary franchise.
Final Fantasy Mobile, great. Genesis Rhapsodos, that said. Oh, is this the, this is the, like, chibi remake of Final Fantasy VII, isn't it? Or not? Well, all these cool costumes. Sorry, Izzy. No Final Fantasy 13 for you. Monster Fantasy. Final Hunter Fantasy 7. Ever Crisis, that was it.
Pre-registration for Final Fantasy 7 Ever Crisis has just started, and users will have the chance to participate in an upcoming closed beta test.
Make now, that a console Fantasy, game or, you know, PC game. I'll play it.
No. Today, during Summer Game Fest, DoorDash has your back. Get
oh, great.
You get a free burrito.
Fuck off.
When you order from Taco
Jesus
Bell
Christ.
Game Fest. Plus, get the chance to win a Final Fantasy 16
fucking
prize
hell.
Pack. DoorDash, stay in your game. Yep, we got you. All right. Now here's a look at a game we debuted last year at TGA. Banisher's Ghosts of New Eden, the story of two ghost hunters in the haunted wilds of North America.
Life to the living, death to the dead. We are banishers.
Oh, yeah, I vaguely remember seeing this.
For those who live. We bring closure to those who don't. I want us back, Red. I want revenge on what killed me. I want to live.
A god of war?
As the man says, we face a choice, simple and awful.
I banish you. Death to the dead.
Do we kill? To be together again?
Yeah, this could be good.
Or do we part forever?
Come out, wherever you are. Come on, show yourself.
Red.
Every bloody time.
Oh, yeah, here we go.
今回の指令は あなた好みの単純な力仕事です。 ある人物を警護していただきます。 頼みましたよ。 コードネーム、上流。 大丈夫か?
ええ。 お待たせしてしまって。
トラブル発生。 車はまだか? 到着まで3分。何があった？お前らも今回り右すりゃ無事に出る。さもなきゃこれから起きることは全部お前らの選んだ結果だ。いやいやいやいや。What?
Sick. Yeah, like some kind of like whip or something. Why to carry you, yeah. What is this fucking anime looking town?
It's
the man with no name. Oh, a man who raised his name. We're getting a release day. Oh, it's near my birthday. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, there was a leak earlier. Stanley. Okay.
It is 7:32 a.m.
As gadgets when he's wearing wearing the glasses. It's like Mission Impossible.
Stan.
Oh, I'm well excited for that.
Good morning, just Stan.
Base to capsule 12. Come in. You there, Stan?
Green across the board. Looks like we're good.
I think they've shown this before, haven't they?
Definitely a leak here, Tim.
How long has it been now?
This new Joryu guy seems pretty cool. I like that. New JoJo character, Joryu.
What operation are they running down here?
They shouldn't be here.
This looks really nice.
This doesn't make sense. Is someone else down here? No.
Matt, are you there?
Under the waves. That looks nice.
It's a beautiful new game, Under the Waves, and today, incidentally...
Can I just say I appreciate that people in the crowd actually got excited
Call of Duty.
For Yakuza.
Well, there's a new Call of Duty coming this fall, along with Warzone Mobile. Today, we're going to give you the first ever look at Season 4 of Modern Warfare 2 Warzone, launching next week. Here's your first look at Vondel, a new Warzone location with points of interest, including a medieval castle, a soccer stadium, and an abandoned zoo. Yep, it's all happening.
Sorry, I don't understand. What is a soccer? Look, let me get it. I'll say it. I think I'd usually say this. Call of Duty's a good game. I just really not interested because it's essentially been this roughly the same game since 2007 now. I find it very hard to get excited as a result. But it looks good. Cool. Funny enough, actually, I do wonder how much money they make off of this. I can't imagine it's, like, apart from, like, season passes or whatever, I can't imagine there's too many people buying costumes for this.
Season 4, next week. Today is a big day for video games, but also a huge day for Porsche. The iconic German automaker turned 75 years old.
What is it with these fucking game showcases and having to show a car off of some kind?
In some point at a game, Xbox has teamed up with Porsche for a limited
edition. Of course, Xbox teamed up with the car company.
Inspired by six famous Porsche race cars. And I'm thrilled to debut the first design here today, inspired by the Porsche 963 that's racing this weekend at the 100th running of the 24 Hours of Le Mans. Let's take a look.
Jesus. Are we putting all of the boring shit together? So COD, this, and Fortnite, maybe?
And here it is, the Porsche Xbox Series X. These custom consoles are not for sale, but you can enter for a chance to win one right now at PorscheXboxSweepstakes.com. Make sure to stay tuned for the Porsche and Xbox social channels for additional opportunities to get your hands on these special consoles. All right.
I'm all right, thanks.
Phoenix Labs are building the next great entry into the cozy farm sim genre. Uh-oh. Like a cozy game inspired by classics like
It's
Animal
been a while since you've had
previously announced for Nintendo
a farming
Switch,
game.
There's now some exciting news for PC players too. Let's take a look at Fae Farm.
Dear friend, life in Azorius has been treating me well.
I know a certain person who's gonna potentially like this.
So quickly.
Yep, there you
Before
go.
Before I know it, they turn into seasons. It's been a breath of fresh air. I think we found a way to get cozy and settle in. But there's something more I've been itching to explore. Realms where magic comes to meet us. As long as we're prepared, we can face anything.
So it's a bit combat-y as well.
What do you say? There's so much yet to discover. Are you ready?
September 8th. Yeah, if that one game wasn't on Switch, then all hell would have broken loose, I think.
Same show, only at Summer Game Fest. Now, please welcome Ben Brode, Chief Development Officer and flannel enthusiast at Second Dinner, the developers behind the popular collectible card game Marvel Snap. What's up, Ben?
I like flannel shirts, too.
Man, you guys have been on fire. Last time I saw you was at the Game Awards when you won Best Mobile Game. Seems like you've been very busy. We're excited about the Spider-Verse content you've been doing. Lots going on over there, right?
Yeah, it's been exciting. We've been doing a bunch of new features, some of the wildest cards we've ever made. And
this guy's too excited for me. Yeah, dial it back a bit.
Segue, Ben?
Certainly, yeah. I'm excited to announce Marvel Snap's biggest update ever. We have a new game mode coming next week.
Calm down.
It's Conquest mode. It's a great way to get a super competitive experience and some exciting.
You're not commentating an esports match.
You don't
match.
Have to wait until next week. If you haven't tried Marvel Snap, go download it right now on your mobile device or early access on Steam.
All right, Ben. I love the enthusiasm, Ben.
That's what I got. That's
you. Sake. Yeah, he's born hyped.
All right,
yeah.
Well, we heard you brought something fun with you for us to watch, right?
Oh, yeah. So, listen. I am incredible at card games, so I often win. But some people...
Apparently this is pretty good.
Maybe you've had this experience, Jeff. Some people lose.
Yeah. Okay. Fair.
And I like to think it's because they suck. No offense, Jeff. But sometimes...
Yes.
Sometimes it's because they might just be a little bit unlucky.
Cue the tape.
Oh, snap.
Okay, I don't have an ideal hand of cards
okay.
here, but that's fine. I'll see what I draw in future turns. Anyway, let's reveal the first location.
Lamuntis 1. Each player destroys their deck.
Okay, I guess I will work with what I have. I'll play Medusa on location number 2. She gets +2 power. And let's see the next location.
Clover Dangerfield has a 25% chance of destroying your cow.
Okay, well, I mean, 25% isn't that bad. And it's gone. Okay, well, I have some powerful cards in my hand, so I can just wait. Let's see the next location.
The Big Barn. Players cannot play 4, 5, or 6 cost cows.
You gotta be kidding me.
Also, if you don't play a card this turn, you have 0 friends.
Now you're just being me.
Still to come, we're going to look at
what's that got to do with the game, though?
From EA Originals and Ascendant,
apart from just advertising it again.
First look at Chapter 4, Season 3 of Fortnite Wilds. Now, if you're looking for the smartest way to level up your gaming this summer, compare top credit cards side by side with NerdWallet and start maximizing your cash back.
Holy shit, he's sponsored by fucking everyone this year.
Here's a look at King Arthur Legends Rise, a new cross-platform UE5 game for mobile and PC, a Fantasy Squad RPG adventure that is available to pre-register today.
Kabam.
Arthur, I have sacrificed everything to save your kind. From an ancient evil.
Is a like fantasy slash medieval games coming back all of a sudden?
Fight
or something.
With honor. Vanquish the wicked. And you
see you later, Pingu.
Prove worthy of your legacy.
Yeah, all right. That looks like Dauntless.
Wayfinders, do you remember the fall? The gloom descended on Skylight. You rallied to protect the beacon and paid a terrible price.
I think this was in early access or something. Well, there was a beta the other month for this.
Remember,
forget the name of it though.
To us. This world needs champions.
Wayfinder. One of the guys at work played the beta. He wasn't super impressed, but not sure if it's his kind of game. Oh, cool. Oh, let's make it look like fucking Call of Duty. Is that a Call of Duty map? Are they just making it look like Call of Duty now? Well, okay, they're just going mental. Just make it every game. Oh, it's for the editor, okay.
Steve, seriously, you don't stand a chance.
Ian?
Project under construction.
You've not missed anything cool, Mono. Not really. The Laris Nexus.
What do you say, guys? One more game?
Good morning, Scavenger. Scan your surroundings to retrieve and recycle anything that could be of value to Scavex.
Space trash.
Captain's log, stardate 43152.4. Our fleet is cautiously entering hostile territory. And the crew is standing by.
This can be a strategy game, do you think?
We are the Borg. Lower your shields and surrender your ships.
Does it always have to be the fucking Borg?
Resistance is futile.
Infinite.
Hey there, Summer Game Fest 2023. It's Will Arnett here. Yeah, right? My buddy Anthony Mackey and I have been working on this for some time now. We're really excited to share with you Twisted Metal, which is streaming only on Peacock.
Oh, yeah, they're doing the show, aren't they?
And I'm very excited to share a sneak peek of the character of Sweet Tooth, who I had the pleasure of voicing. Hope you enjoy it. Check it out.
This is gonna be fun! Machete!
Ha! Swung a little wide there.
Well, aren't we a tall glass of water? Me? I'm more of a Hawaiian punch! I'm guessing you don't fight much outside of your car now, do you?
Look, clown. I don't need four wheels to kick your ass.
Any chance we can get this back in the cars?
How about a little kill music?
This is... I feel like this is a really weird franchise to turn into a series.
Dumps like a truck. That's like what? All night long.
Right?
Let me see that thong.
Like it when the beat go?
Da-da-da-da.
Baby, let your booty go.
Da-da-da-da.
Wait, is it a comedy?
Da-da-da-da. Do you love the silver haired god? Huh? Don't lie to me.
Yeah, man. Look, I listened to Unleash the Dragon so many times the disc broke. I'm not a liar.
But you said you were coming to my show. And then you shot at me.
It was a misunderstanding. I've been getting shot at ever since I can remember. It's forced habit, I guess.
Sounds like you have trust issues.
Sweet Tooth's like a super bad guy in the games, right?
Who hasn't dreamt of duplicating oneself in order to multitask? This new hack and slash game with a tactical twist allows you to do just that. Brought to you from France, here's the world premiere reveal trailer of Lisfanga, the Time Shift Warrior, coming later this year to PC.
Okay, does the game look like that? Because that looks cool.
Goddess of Time.
Receive my light, Lisfanga. Let this power flow through you and fight again alongside your past selves.
I'm here again. That's another me.
I look good.
I rewind. I begin again, but with another me to fight with.
So, is it like a puzzle game?
You're coming with me.
You have to like work out how to do each fight.
You're not the only one who can be in multiple places at once.
Like both, yeah, I don't know. Grow your army
and crush these demons. Onwards.
I can feel that there are more.
Interesting.
Very cool independent game. All right, next up is a brand new IP from Ascendant Studios, a single-player, first-person magic shooter called Immortals of Avium. It's fast and fluid. It's an FPS in a fantasy setting.
Oh, this game.
Kind of like Doom with magic.
It also has a great cast
led by Darren Barnett as the main character, Jack, and he joins us now. Hey, Darren.
Hey, guys.
Great to have you with
How
us.
You doing? Thank you.
This
EA
is such,
kicking this out
a cool
to its
game.
Death.
Super high production value, spectacular gameplay.
There was a Power World sighting earlier, Wing,
the main character, Jack, right?
Yes, I am playing the main character, Jack, as seen behind me. He is a battle mage that controls all three forms of magic, triple threat. He's brash, he's funny, but he gets the job done.
Well, it's the gameplay, as we've seen, is just so fast-paced. There's so much action in it, you know, with all the spells.
You think, Ian? I don't see it being pushed that much.
What can you tell us about the story and sort of how this battle mage, Jack, comes in? He sort of becomes a battle mage, right?
Yeah, he kind of comes from nothing. He's, I guess they call him a street rat is what he was. But he,
it looks fine. It just looks like the power
to control magic. Becomes part of the Immortals.
Which is fine, which is like actually. Just that's all you need, really, isn't it? It doesn't need to be
of this world called Avium.
Mind-blowingly amazing.
Fighting for the control of magic.
Okay, you have a great cast. You, Gina Torres, in it. Lots of amazing actors in this incredible, really high production value game that's coming out this summer. We don't have to wait long for it. And I know you brought something with you to share today, which is a gameplay sequence, which is one of the most epic sort of parts of the game, right?
Yeah. So this is a wild part of the game. This trailer is going to be showing you the Immortals and myself confronting Sandrak directly, who is the top villain of this game, and trying to end the Everwar. And it's taking place in like one of the most badass levels of a video game I've seen. We're battling on top of a 400-foot mech in the middle of the ocean as it moves around. It's wild, so let's take a look.
All right, let's take a look at some brand new gameplay from Immortals of Avium, which comes out this summer for PC, PS5, and Xbox. Thanks, Darren.
Thank you.
Sandrax literally pushed us to the edge. Everyone that can fight already is.
See, just like fantasy, magic, medieval, slash you know, whatever games. I mean, that looks pretty cool.
Welcome aboard, Immortal. What's our bearing, sir?
North by northeast. 5 knots.
We'll catch him, sir.
Thing is, if it is really good, I hope it does well so that EA make more of this kind of stuff. Kind of get a little bit of BioShock from this. Like combat wise. Have a lot to say about it. That's the problem. I don't think it looks bad. I think it just kind of looks a bit like just kind of fine.
I want to be an immortal. I want to fight this war as one of you.
You're what's called a triarch. The Pentasod has gifted you with the ability to manifest all three colors of magic.
Also, like, I don't know, listening to this story, I'm just like, I don't give a fuck about the story from what they've shown of it so far.
We're only going to win this one together. Sigil up.
Sigil up. Yeah, I don't know.
Love that we get to show you guys so much amazing raw gameplay today, and that game looks incredible. Coming out this summer from Ascendant and EA. Now, one game that constantly reinvents itself is Fortnite. And tomorrow, Chapter 4 Season 3 Wilds launches. And today, Summer Game Fest is debuting the cinematic
Chapter 4 Season 3.
The center of the island has collapsed, revealing a vast hidden jungle with ancient secrets to discover.
Oh shit, is that Optimus Prime in Fortnite?
Battle Pass lineup where you can unleash the power, yes, of Cybertron. Here we go.
Oh no, Ian's gonna have to play it. Sorry, Ian. You're doomed. Imagine if they don't get Optimus's real voice, though. Jurassic Park as well? Sure, why not? Ian, really? I thought the new film looked quite good. Doesn't look right proportion wise. And he's not talking.
Launches.
What have they done to my precious boy?
Finally, guys, it's time to get to our grand finale. And it is a deep honor for me to present this game. What you're about to see is a world premiere trailer that gives us a new look at an expansive world we can't wait to explore again. This game comes from a studio that surprised the world and redefined the RPG genre with its iconic characters and rich storytelling. And I want to thank them for this trailer for one of gaming's most anticipated upcoming releases. The rumors were true.
We're still here at the scene.
Ah, yes. Okay. Get in my eyes.
01 and 02. Amidst the wreckage of the expressway, search and rescue operations are already in progress.
Wait, are they just all dead? Are we going to get a release date, though?
Wow. Just look at it all. It's so green. Even after everything we've done to it, it's still going strong.
It may look that way, but in reality, it's barely hanging on.
I was wondering, what's Cloud been doing these past 5 years? Where's he been?
And you're asking me this?
This is gonna sound crazy, but as far as I know, Cloud was never in Nibelheim 5 years ago.
The life stream. It is the very essence of our star. The blood coursing through its planetary veins.
According to Hojo, they're connected to Sephiroth. Shadows of the Mad, I believe he called them.
Sephiroth was in Midgar. We fought him. Whatever happened, he's alive.
But why come back now? After 5 years, doing who knows what?
Well now, think we woke it up.
Angered it, more like.
So we can play, you can play as Reds.
Keep your eyes on the Turk's latest this time. And greatest, Elena.
She may be new, but she's still a Turk.
Oh, look, it's Andrew Tate. I felt fucking dirty saying that, to be honest. Oh, is that the cannon they make? Was it to fight one of the weapons, wasn't it? Oh, they got like link up moves.
What the? Get away from me!
They say she's a monster. That she can peer inside you, into the very depths of your soul. That she can become those you hate, those you fear, those you love.
Bring you in.
You murdered my dad! You burned my village!
You know that I killed her. So, who is she?
Release date, I reckon it'll be next March. Oh yeah, on two discs. Whoa.
There you have it. That was Final Fantasy VII Rebirth coming early 2024 to PlayStation 5. Nomura-san, thank you so much. All right.
That's Where's Kojima?
Summer Game Fest, our live showcase, but that is not the end of Summer Game Fest. Stay tuned this weekend for updates on many more games during SGF Play Days, a hands-on event for media here in Los Angeles, including Cyberpunk 2077, Phantom Liberty, as well as the Xbox and Bethesda showcase on Sunday. Right now, though, stay tuned
PC version coming 2036
and Double Fine, which celebrates the independent game culture with a number of new game reveals over the next hour. We'll see you this summer, later this summer, on August 22nd for Gamescom Opening Night Live in Germany, and again in December when we come together here in Los Angeles to celebrate 10 years of the Game Awards. Thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you soon.
We'll do this quick, because I don't know if they're going to quickly go into the next thing, but... That was not as good as I expected it to be. Like, Final Fantasy was cool, and there was a few other big ones. But there wasn't anything, like, major there, right? That was, that was a little bit disappointing, honestly. Oh, yeah, actually, no, to be fair, yeah, Prince of Persia looked cool. Sonic I need to see more of. But I'm always very critical of Sonic games, or, like, because I want them to be amazing. But, not the best. Final Fantasy and Yakuza were the only interesting things. Right, yeah. There was a bit more for me, but... Sandland looks pretty good, yeah. It looked good, but it didn't... I need to see more of it, I think, before I can kind of... I need to see kind of more how it plays before I can judge that one. We'll say, though, nothing made my nipples hard. All right. But yeah, I think that's it. So, hang on, let's just cap it off by saying... Yeah. For the most part, yeah.